Sometimes when picking the games we'd like to do for this show, we try and include some weird ones that you might not see coming. We may do this for several different reasons, one of them being that we don't just want to cover the most popular games of every genre. Very early on, we decided we wanted to talk about games that nobody else would, due to a need to talk about relevant topics. Another being that the script can be a little less involved and allow us to try different things. For this episode, we cover a game that we chose for these reasons, yet somehow as we started playing it, it became clear that not only were we not going to have any fun, but that we were going to have to commit to learning what the f*** was going on if we were going to be able to talk about it. Today, we're going to be talking about Police Quest, SWAT, for the PC. The Police Quest series was developed and published by Sierra Entertainment and began in 1987 with the first entry in the series titled Police Quest in Pursuit of the Death Angel. Sierra Entertainment has developed PC games like King's Quest and Leisure Suit Larry. They were acquired by Vivendi in 1998, who were eventually bought by Activision in 2008. Today, the Sierra name is used by Activision as a publishing label beginning with Geometry Wars 3. The first three games in the Police Quest series were point-and-click adventure games, looking and playing exactly like other games released around that time. With the first being criticized for being a bit slow when it comes to the police work, the second two improved upon the formula and are remembered fondly. The games were known for their focus on realistic police simulation and were actually worked on by police officer turned game designer Jim Walls. He retired from the police force after 15 years after a shooting incident, which left him traumatized. After Walls left Sierra in 1992, retired officer Daryl Gates took over as the series producer. With Police Quest Open Season, the series dropped the numbered entries and changed significantly. While not going into full FMV territory, the art style is a more photorealistic style than it was before, and it also featured more gore and realism than previous titles. The game did generate controversy, however, for its portrayal of certain African-American characters. This brings us to Police Quest SWAT, released in 1995. Known for its extensive use of full motion video, the game came on 4 CDs. When it was released, it mostly received negative reviews. It didn't sell well either, and it was 3 years until another game in the series was released. Police Quest SWAT 2 changed genres once again to a tactics game and received much more positive reception than its two predecessors. SWAT 3 and SWAT 4 saw the series switch to a first-person shooter. With no new games in over a decade, Jim Walls launched a Kickstarter for a spiritual successor titled Precinct in 2013. However, after multiple unsuccessful attempts to fund the game, it was abandoned. We play as SWAT Pup, the new guy on the job. While he has 6 years of experience as a police officer, he's still got a lot to learn before becoming the big dog on the team. And that's what this game is about, a lot of learning. When you start, you'll be given so much information that it's hard to understand what the game really wants from you. We start with a lecture from some officers, and if you skip it, you get verbally reprimanded.
Officer, you dare interrupt a superior? Let me warn you. Insubordination is not tolerated around here. Never has been, never will be. Is that clear, officer?
After we're given access to a large amount of information on everything from officers, guns, tactics, and much, much more. After all of the training, we get to go to one of the game's three missions. Each of these missions can be completed in multiple different ways. For example, going in through the front or the back can lead to extremely different experiences. However, these are random, so you can't choose what you want to do and may end up repeating the same things over and over again. This is a problem, because the first two missions' variants have to be completed multiple times in order to unlock the third mission. These three SWAT missions can best be described as a deranged grandmother, a barricaded fugitive, and a terrorist attack. As I mentioned earlier, the game features extensive use of full motion video in everything from the cutscenes to the gameplay. While it doesn't look awful, most of the performances are exceptionally cringy in a direct-to-DVD movie kind of way. During gameplay, you'll hear voiceover from the sergeant giving orders and other officers yelling things at you, but these performances are actually worse than the acting. The game is played from a first-person perspective most of the time, switching to third-person for conversations and sometimes to show your movement. This definitely gets weird, because you don't always know where you are during the gameplay. I hope you like hearing the same MIDI files constantly, because that's what this game consists of musically. While we didn't expect much going into it, the music is extremely repetitive throughout, and it becomes very frustrating early on. After the information overload, you'll be set loose to do your training, which must be completed before a mission is available to you, the first of which is a small arms range. You'll be told to get out a certain weapon and shoot specific spots on the target. Seems pretty simple, and it is. Just boring. The lines are repeated over and over again, and hearing the exact same sound clip repeated 2 seconds later can get very annoying.
Officers, come to your guard. Single to the head, semi-auto. Single to the head, semi-auto. On the whistle.
The fun part is that it doesn't tell you when you're done. We thought we were doing something wrong, so we played this section for upwards of a half a f***ing hour. We restarted the game, we tried everything we could. Turns out, you just have to leave the range at a certain point, which the game doesn't tell you. Next is the combat range, which has you shooting targets a certain amount of times in a specific order. I forgot to mention that both of these exercises are also timed, so if you don't hit these targets fast enough, then you have to do it again. The last of these is sniper training, which is the most straightforward of the bunch. However, it's still not in the least bit fun. After another lecture on tactics, it's time to go on your first mission. An old woman is held up in her home with a gun, and you have to go in there and stop her without killing her. Once you get to the home, you'll have the opportunity to talk to some witnesses before being briefed on exactly what you'll be doing. While the mission can be played in many different ways, it's not up to you which way you'll be playing it. Out of the many, many times we played this mission, we only got to go in the house a different way one time. We're not quite sure if this is usual for the game or not, but it's what we experienced. Once the mission begins, you'll mostly just be following orders. This can be either equipping one of your items, or using the LASH radio system to issue commands. LASH stands for Los Angeles SWAT Headset. Creative name, right? This is not dynamic though, as you have to do specific things in a specific order to advance. These can include slicing the pie to see everything in the room, using a mirror to look around the corner into the next room, or just using your gun to cover a certain area. If you don't do exactly what the game wants, then a number of bad things can happen. If an officer gets killed, or you shoot them, you get this hilarious cutscene almost immediately. If you don't follow orders, then you could be kicked off the mission and have to wait until you could do it again. The same happens if you shoot the suspect. All of the outcomes lead to some pretty funny dialogue from other officers when you get back to the main office. No matter what though, you can just wait a while and you'll be able to get back to the mission if you don't want to reload your game. This is the part where I tell you that we never got farther than the first mission. We played it so many times before we beat it, that we couldn't stomach the thought of finishing that game. We were following a walkthrough word for word, and still had trouble completing it. SWAT's main problem is that it gives you little to no direction on what to do. You're actually supposed to study and learn these tactics before going into the missions. From learning how to use verbal commands, how to use the hand signals, and typical SWAT procedures, it's almost like you're actually going to school to learn how to be in the SWAT force. It seems like the developers intended for the players to spend hours reading, learning, and studying the material provided in order to play this game flawlessly. Which means that this game could only really appeal to a very small number of people. What is there good to say about this game? If you've gotten this far into the video, then you know that Police Quest SWAT doesn't hold up. It's not fun in any sense of the word, and it's hard for me to believe that it even was at the time. While some people have nostalgia for this game, I think that it stops there. The only reason anyone should ever play this game is if you need a good laugh. And even then, it's hard to recommend in a look how bad this game is kind of way. I guess if you want to learn about SWAT tactics in the 90s, this game is right up your alley. Wow!